32 degrees outside the window on 8th Street, 92.1 WROI. WROIFM.com, streaming audio live, RTC Channel 5, and soon to have audio and video on RTC Channel 5. That's why Brant's in the studio. Nice to have you here. All right. Time now for our chamber chat. Executive Director Amy Rowe with us. Hey, Amy, good morning.
Hey, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing okay.
Excellent.
Wish the allergies would go away, but hey.
Hey, tis spring in Indiana.
Amen. At least it's warm, right?
That's exactly right. For the most part, it is warm. I know the chamber doesn't have anything going on right now.
Nothing at all. We're just sitting there and staring at the wall, waiting for exciting, drinking our Diet Mountain Dew, just hanging out, right?
That's exactly
which
right.
Which we need.
Actually, busy times for the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce.
It is. It's a good time. You know, we had our gala. Obviously, that was a true success and, you know, still kind of riding on the waves of that. And it was quite an eventful month, but excited about that and just the success and heard some really positive things. So looking forward to, I believe, as long as the date is confirmed, the 14th of April next year, hoping for Akron. So that was what we wanted to do this year, but...
Excellent.
Keep working on that.
You bet.
And we've got Women in Business. So the follow-up, the second one for Inspire. We've got Dr. Allison Barber.
Okay.
And when I was looking at her bio, I think people will be equally inspired and probably scared to death as they were with Mayor Milo last year. Mm-hmm. She was the Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense, which is kind of amazing.
It's impressive.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
And she's been 25 years in education. So wow. She's the chancellor of WGU.
Oh,
and she's trying to talk me into getting my master's.
Okay.
So
that's Western Governors University, right?
Mm-hmm,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
That was something that Mitch Daniels, before he became president of Purdue, had highlighted in his administration.
Yes. And from what I understand, I've only spoken to her about it once. We spoke about potentially doing the master's program, following up with that. It seems like a unique model.
It does.
I don't fully understand it. I'm hoping I can speak to her on the 9th when she comes here. But being able to be an actual adult working and still work at your own pace. So
excellent.
I will learn more about it.
So what's the date for that again?
June 9th. So that's Friday morning, June 9th. Registration is open. And we would love folks to get that. We recognize most folks do registration last minute. So,
but
that's open and we're excited about that. And then September 8th is the final date. So we'll work that one out and get all the details. But
all right.
The thing that we're really engaged in right now is that pint-sized young lady that you met the other day.
That's the parade chairman, right?
The parade chairman. So Miss Lauren Evers, we are so gracious. That are so grateful to her for choosing us to do her internship. So obviously brain drain usually goes that way, but we're hoping they'll come back. So Lauren comes to us from Ball State, and she has taken the task of doing the parade, and we're also doing something fun. My board had given me the go ahead to do some decorating of the offices. And so we've got new paint, new carpet that happened last year.
Okay.
And but we walk in and you look and the walls are all bare. We can't have that. So we're trying to figure out how in the world can we get those walls to be decorated. So what we're going to do in combination with the parade is a photo contest. LMA does this contest with Hardesty Printing.
Right.
And it's for the calendar.
Right.
So I talked to Blake and he said I could do this, that we're going to do something similar to put canvases. So 5 photos kind of throughout the whole community. And so Lauren's job is to figure out the details to work with them and figure that out. And then it's going to be displayed here at the Living Local Fest.
That'll be excellent.
Yes, so everybody's working hard. Glenn Goss from Snubbletier, he's doing with Chrissy Rossworm and the Rochester Downtown Partnership, the Living Local Fest. And what we're hoping for is to create a new memory brand. Living Local is something that's pretty 21st century and will never replace the Round Barn Festival
by
any stretch of the imagination, but is something that could be a memory each year that people love to come to. So having the parade and then having local artisans be able to showcase what they have to offer. So
as far as the pictures go, if I snap that photo on my phone, what do I do with it then?
So Lauren's going to figure those details out.
Okay.
So we don't have all the details yet. She is working diligently on that. But I've given her the deadline of Tuesday.
Okay.
So keep your eyes peeled. All of that will go in all the media and let people know. And we hope to have some good judges and no more bare walls.
All right. Excellent idea. Sure.
Yes. So, okay. And that date for the parade is June 24th.
Okay.
As we spoke about earlier, there's about 1.5 million things going on that day. So make sure you drink lots of Diet Mountain Dew and take a nap in between. But
what time do we kick that off?
9 a.m. for the parade.
Okay.
So the lineup will be at, I believe, 7:30.
All right.
At RHS. And then obviously the route had to change a little bit again. We're trying to get all this settled, but with the 9th and Main project going on,
right,
obviously we can't anticipate that there will not be large right. equipment in right. the road. So we will go down 8th Street and then down Main Street and turn left on 8th Street.
Okay.
So.
Just, and I know that the weather for that day will be absolutely perfect.
Of course, because we're going to order it.
Just in case. Would we have a rain delay or a rain date or?
We haven't discussed that as of okay. yet. Okay. I think that we all just have crossed fingers and hope for the best.
Absolutely.
You know, obviously that's a great idea, but we haven't discussed that okay. at the moment. So we started planning just last week and.
Well, I'm sure the weather will be perfect. So.
Well, I need you to put orders in all headquarters right.
we'll
to make that happen.
We'll be in charge of the weather, so you have no issues whatsoever.
Put a work order in. We don't have time for a rain delay.
That's right. We do not.
So, and then something fun, which I love to re-highlight, because we always talk about, you always ask me why chamber membership.
Sure.
So one of the fun things that we did this year was that tool talk.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the YouTube videos that we do to highlight the different benefits of the membership. And this month we're going to do our one on the business minute
okay.
and how to use it. And we've got Snobbleteer and Tibby Valley. So the platypus from Snobbleteer may be making an appearance on our tool talk video to talk about the importance of using the tool of the business minutes, the newsletter, to get out to the 600 sure. people that we have there. So just letting folks know what the benefit is and how to use it and make it a little bit fun and engaging. No one wants to hear me drone on forever. So we'll let a platypus come in and that will probably increase the rating. So besides that, you know, that's all the chamber stuff. There's always okay. stuff we're working on, getting membership plaques okay. out and everything. But tourism.
Yeah, let's talk about tourism.
Pretty excited about it.
I'll bet.
Yeah, we had our first meeting, like I spoke to you last time. We have our officers. I get to be president just for a little bit.
Congratulations.
Because I'm the only one standing, last man standing. and then vice president is Kim Martin. She's out of Akron.
Right.
Which, so grateful that, you know, we have the county designation. And secretary is Melinda Klinger, because okay. she just happens to be, she should be a lifetime secretary. She's just great.
She's a tourism guru of Fulton
she
County, basically.
Is. And she's a great secretary. She's right. just, that's one of her skill sets. And then treasurer is Russ Breidinger. Mm-hmm. Used to manage the hotels and motels mm-hmm. and sassy as can be, but loves his numbers. We sat down yesterday to talk budget and the man had like about 50,000 papers. And for me, it's easier than that. And, you know, I was like, we already figured out. We just need to back into the number. And he had calculated all these Excel spreadsheets. But I'm so grateful for him. So we've got a good team. We've got a marketing and structure and grant committee.
Okay.
Each of those is working diligently. I'm just grateful that it's actually moving now. So we're hoping to get things moving. Our next meeting is June 14th, and everybody's marching orders
okay.
are that they're supposed to be done with their task by June 14th. So we're working on the video, websites, getting the grant application process streamlined and updated. And hopefully, we're not 100% sure, but obviously the trailhead building that the group there is working on, one of the potential possibilities is to house that Visitor and Convention Bureau, Fulton County Tourism mm-hmm. Commission, in that, to be able to have a place that actually is part of tourism and to be able to have folks have a place to come in. And we'd like to have the video running like they do in Marshall County and propagate the story of Fulton County as much as we can. And it makes sense to have it somewhere where lots of visitors are. So lots of things that need to be worked out, but the wheels are turning. And
will we be applying for a grant then with this, with the tourism?
For the trailhead building?
Well, either that or for the whole tourism concept.
We've looked into it with some of the marketing.
Right.
But unfortunately, the state of Indiana has decided to put those on hold. At the moment.
At the moment.
Yes.
Okay.
I've told Adam that was unacceptable. I've been there a couple times to the tourism office down in Indy just to bird dog them a little bit. They're very helpful. But I guess that they, I don't know if they didn't have as many folks. That's what he said, but they didn't feel the return on investment for the grant was effective. I said, but Fulton County is ready to do it.
Sure, ready to go.
Yeah. So we'll continue to look at opportunities. The video will be a partnership between IUK and the Tourism Commission. And Stephen Ray, who does our grant planning, he has money that he can pay IUK for us to do a video with the students there. So we're trying to work out those details. So it's not a grant per se that we applied for, but somebody else on our behalf. So.
Where does the video appear?
What our hope is, obviously on the website.
Right.
And when we were looking at what do we want for a video, I've talked to, Ted's talked to me about this and Terry, and we need something to showcase Fulton County.
I would
Argus
agree with that.
Did a great job. If you look at the video, you think, dear Lord, it's like California or something.
Right.
It's beautiful. We need something like that to tell our story. So our hope is that we can get something that we can not only put on the website, but if Mayor Denton goes out there and does something, or Terry, that they can take that with them.
Okay.
And then if the trailhead building does come to fruition, that we can have a loop and have that just rolling in that loop. Marshall County Tourism does that. Okay. I'm always jealous. I sit on the couch and watch and with envy every time I see that video. So
RTC Channel 4.
And RTC. Whoever will let us, all the media sources, just have it wherever. Because we need to.
Right.
That's the thing, is that I feel like multiple media sources, multiple opportunities, somehow we just don't get the word out.
Can the Chamber website accommodate that video? For example, when we do the first federal program on Friday morning, they Facebook that live, and then they put it on the Facebook page for people who want to come in later and watch that particular video.
Yeah. You know, we're looking at that. As far as with the, one of the things that we struggle with the most is the separation of the organizations. We're trying to help folks understand, because you get blamed for everything, but you also get praised for everything, right?
Right.
And the organizations, the tourism, the Main Street, and the Chamber, we want to partner together, but have that separate entity so we know. What we've done with the Rochester Downtown Partnership is we have a tab on there that folks can go. So probably we'd do something similar, have a tab for tourism, and then direct it to the website that we paid quite a bit of money for. Just so that, driving traffic. But we do need to be able to point to each other and let everybody know what's going on.
Yeah, I think the simplest thing, or the thing that you want to do that to make it simple, is because you want people from surrounding communities, from surrounding states, from wherever, to be able to access that video and enjoy what they see about Fulton County.
And web presence is so important.
Exactly.
That was one of the things that I realized when I was in South Carolina. I attempted to research Fulton County and do a marketing plan, and I either couldn't find anything or it just didn't seem to be cohesive. So we feel very, very, very dedicated to the project, trying to figure out how in the world we can get a web presence and give the perception that we are the best thing since sliced bread.
Sure.
So we are working diligently to try to get those websites updated and done and be able to share our story.
Speaking of the best things since sliced bread, how about the chili cook-off? Have you started working on that in October?
Yes, of course. We haven't done anything specific except for Stacey Wilson kind of hoodwinked someone that secretly showed up last year that might potentially be able to help us with something secret.
Good.
So I've already had people ask and kind of plot like what their recipe is going to be and figuring out all the details. So it's not the 25th, but hey, you know, chili cook-off's the best thing. I love it. I'm just hoping
you got to start another 25 years somewhere.
I know. That's what? So we got a lot of good things going on, and it definitely keeps us hopping.
Okay.
And that's why we have to have the Diet Mountain Dew.
Amy Rose, Executive Director of the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce. Anything else you'd like to pass along this morning?
No. We just are so grateful to be able to have another month to work, and so grateful for our intern, Aaron Brooks. Obviously, I had a broken wing for a hot second. Now we're trying to do therapy, so he covered for me in getting those membership plaques. Obviously, we want to apologize for not getting those out as quickly as possible, but Aaron was so gracious to bring his smile around and drop those off, so.
Why Chamber membership?
Always and forever, because it's a tool to multiply your company's needs, to tell the story of your company through our tool.
Monday through Friday, you're open?
Yep, 8 to 5.
And, right downtown.
Yep, sweet Beth sitting there with her great smile and helpful attitude.
If I go online to find the chamber, how do I do that?
www.fultoncountychamber.com. You're going to try to trick me, weren't you?
Just that simple, isn't it?
Just that simple.
You will be closed on Memorial Day Monday.
We will.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep, so I probably actually will take a break. I used to all work, right. But I might just rest.
Hey, Miro, thank you very much. Nice to have you here.
Thank you so much. Thanks.